Let's say you want to do something, I don't know, a little bit adventurous, like blow up the sun. Let's just do it. Let's figure out what it would take to blow up the sun. But that seems like a big challenge. That seems like a little bit daunting. So let's, for now, as a way to think about this problem, let's think about something a little bit easier, like, I don't know, blowing up the earth. Yeah, we can get our hands on the earth easier than we can get our hands on the sun. So let's start with blowing up the earth as a practice session. And then we'll go to blowing up the sun once we got some experience under our belt. So there's an intuition that if you want to blow something up like the earth, like the sun, it's going to take energy. You're going to have to do work. You're going to have to apply yourself to this problem to actually blow up the earth. So just as a way to think about this problem, let's say we were going to blow up the earth in the worst way possible, in the slowest way possible. And we're just going to take a rock, one rock from the surface of the earth, and we're going to put it in a rocket, and we're going to send that rocket into space, and we're going to eject that rock with enough escape velocity that it never returns to earth. It just flies away out into space. The rocket might land, we might use it again, that doesn't matter, but we've ejected one rock away from the earth. That took a certain amount of energy. We had to take this rock and we had to give it enough energy to make it go fast enough to reach escape velocity so that it was completely unbound from the earth. It no longer felt the gravitational effects from the earth, and it would never ever return to the earth. It reached escape velocity. It took a certain amount of energy. Okay, so we tally that down. Okay, it took this much energy to do. Then we go to the next rock. Same thing. Okay, it took that much energy to accelerate it, to escape velocity, to unbind it from the earth. And then another rock, and then another rock. And then maybe we start doing heavier rocks. And then we start doing whole chunks of the earth. Like, okay, we got a 10 meter by 10 meter by 10 meter cube that we've dug out of the ground. We're going to put it on our biggest rocket. We're going to eject it from the earth, escape velocity. We're just going to keep adding up the energy we need. How much energy? How much is energy? Now, a strange thing happens. The more we do this, the less mass the earth has. It's losing mass because we're taking it bit by bit and ejecting it out into space. And so every time we do it, it gets a little bit easier, right? Because we've already ejected this chunk, and the earth is now slightly less massive, it has slightly less gravity. It's not as good at keeping things stuck to its surface as it was before, so it'll be a little bit easier for the next chunk to go. And then a little bit easier. And you can imagine like strip mining the top layer of the surface of the earth. Like, okay, we're going to take 1 meter down everywhere around all the mountains and the valleys, and we're going to take 1 meter, shave it off the oceans, and we're going to send that out into space. And then the entire earth will have a radius smaller by 1 meter. And so the amount of energy it will take to get the next meter off will be a little bit less because there's not as much earth holding it back. And you can do this and do this and do this. You can actually approach this mathematically. You do a little bit of calculus magic and you end up with a number, a very specific number that tells you how much energy it takes to unbind something that's bound together with gravity. The earth is held together by its own gravity, by its own mass is pulling in on everything else to making a nice tight little ball. Little in space terms, you understand. A nice tight little ball. And there's a certain amount of energy that you would have to apply, something we call the binding energy, the amount of energy you have to apply to disintegrate the earth. And no matter your technique for destroying the earth, whether you're going to strip mine it layer by layer or have a bunch of bombs or some antimatter or whatever. It doesn't matter how you do it. That's how much energy it's going to take. You may disagree in the particular application of those energies, but that's an engineering problem, not a science problem. Now, how much energy would it take? Well, it depends on the density of your object, the size, the total mass, its radius. And for the Earth, it's somewhere around 10 to the 32 joules. 10 to the 32 joules of energy needed to unbind the Earth. To give you a sense of how much, that's a lot of energy. Let me just say that. To give you a sense of how much energy that is, in 2013, a few years ago, all of humanity, all of us, the billions of us combined, consumed 10 to the 20 joules of energy, which is 1 trillionth the amount of energy needed to unbind the Earth. So that's a lot of energy. It's 1 trillion times more energy than all of humanity consumed in an entire year to do everything, all the stuff that humanity does, is 1 trillionth of the energy needed if you wanted to unbind the Earth. And by the way, I'm going to insert an ad break here. Go to patreon.com/PM Sutter to help support this show. I know that's super awkward, but I got no good segue. So there it is, patreon.com/PM Sutter to help keep this show running. So that's the energy needed to unbind the Earth. But in cosmic terms, that's actually not too much energy. So the sun is outputting a lot of energy. And it's, I have notes here so I don't mess up the numbers. It's about 1 week. 1 week of the sun's total energy output is enough if you could collect all the energy being outputted by our sun. If you could collect it for a week and store it and use it, you would have enough energy to unbind the Earth. But that's collecting all the energy. If you were stuck on Earth, if you couldn't coat the surface of the sun in solar panels or something like something ridiculous like that, that's another episode. If you're stuck at the Earth and you just had to use the energy falling onto the Earth, so the sun is outputting all this tremendous energy, but the Earth is very, very tiny and it's very, very far away from the sun. So only some of it, that energy actually hits the surface of the Earth. If you were to just use the energy that hits the Earth, if you were to coat the surface of our planet 100% in solar panels, and these solar panels were 100% efficient, capturing all that energy day after day after day, the entire surface. This is humanity's new purpose, is to collect enough energy to unbind our own planet. It would take about 18 million years to collect enough energy to unbind the Earth. That's a lot of energy. That's a lot of energy. That is the energy that is stored inside the Earth from the fact that it is glued together with gravity. And that's the amount of energy you have to apply in order to disassociate the whole thing. So that's, we'll take our engineering knowledge that we've done to blow up the Earth, and now we can apply it to the sun. The sun is the exact same process, just bigger. In fact, it'll take, the binding energy of the sun is somewhere around 10 to the 41 joules, 10 to the 41 joules, which is 1 billion times greater than the binding energy of the Earth, because the sun is way more massive and bigger. You're going to have to work a lot harder. So if you could capture all of the sun's output, remember it took about 1 week of the entire sun's output in order to gather enough energy to unbind the Earth. If you wanted to capture all the sun's output, store it, and then apply it to the sun so you ripped it apart, it would take you about 1 billion weeks, or 20 million years of the sun's own energy output in order to unbind it. That's pretty cool. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said, go to patreon.com/PM Sutter. That is how these shows stay running. They support me. Really appreciate it. And you can also like and subscribe, share, make sure notifications are turned on for when I go live, all the usual stuff. You know how it works. And I'll see you next time. Meanwhile, don't blow up the sun.